forget the groceries.
I want them.
You know what, Flicka? We're going to send a telegram.
Ken, how are the folks?
Fine. Mom wants me to bring some things home. Here's the list.
Huh?
There's only one thing she forgot.
What was that?
Character, Flicka.
Well, we'll take care of that right now. There you are.
Thanks, Mr. Peterson.
Ah, you take good care of that horse, don't you? You never forget him.
Not Flicka.
No. Good boy. Well, I'll tell you, why don't you come on in the store with me while I prepare this list, huh? There's a can of jelly beans on the counter.
Oh, I can't. I gotta write on down to the telegraph office. Send a telegram.
Oh, not bad news, I hope.
Oh, no. Our Aunt Hetty back in New Hampshire. She's gonna be 90 years old tomorrow. First time I ever sent a telegram.
Well, that's a pretty important time in a young fellow's life. You better get with it now. Go on and do it.
Okay, thanks a lot again for the carrot.
Mm-hmm.
Bye. Bye. Take a few minutes, Flicka. I gotta make sure that he sends this telegram exactly right. Mr. Neal, I'd like to send a...
Neil?
He's lying on the floor of the telegraph office. It looks like maybe he's dead.
Now you stay right here, Kent. Jim, come on.
All right, we split up here. Meet at the shack later. Here, you take the money. And don't lose any of it, because I know exactly how much is there.
All right. Then why don't you take your share right now?
Oh, no. I can't afford to have that money on me. I'm an honest man. A railroad inspector is going to be out looking for you two guys soon.
Thinks of everything, don't he?
Yeah, I got to admit it, Simmons. You're playing it pretty smart.
You have to when you're a loyal employee of the Wyoming Pacific. Come on, let's go.
Shot in the back.
Oh.
Three men, judging by the tracks. They busted open the safe. There was a money shipment going out on the next train. They got it. Right now, I need a posse. Peterson, Barton, Joe, Bill, come inside. Swearing you men in as deputies. Find shells over there. Help yourself. Give you 5 minutes to shut up shop, and we'll meet back here and ride out together. We'll pick up the trail at the telegraph office.
Oh, Ken.
Yes, sir, Mr. Sheriff. Oh, Mr. Peterson, what about the groceries?
They'll have to wait, son.
Ken, you did real well. Wasted no time at all. You going home now?
Yeah, I guess so.
Here, hold this for me.
Unless I can go with a posse.
Well, I can't officially deputize you, son. You're a little too young. But I'd like to unofficially deputize you to take a message to your father.
Yes, sir.
Tell him to spread the word to the other ranchers out his way to keep a lookout for those three holdup men. So I can round up enough deputies to cover all the roads, huh?
Right away, sir.
And hurry.
Flicka, let's take the shortcut through the wash. Come on.
Come on. Yeah,
What a time to pull up lame.
Hello there, Button. I didn't expect to meet up with anybody on this trail.
What's the trouble, mister?
My horse pulled up lame.
Well, he picked up a stone. It's in kind of deep. My dad usually pulls him out with the shoeing tongs.
Uh-huh. Where are you headed for, Button?
Home, the Goose Bar Ranch. If you wait here till I get back with the shoeing tongs...
I guess you'll have to do the waiting, Button. I'm in a hurry.
Hey, what are you going to do?
Get out.
WPRR, number 47. WPRR. That's Wyoming Pacific Railroad.
Like she's proper broke to me.
She'll be all right after I whip her into line.
Hey, shut her up, will you? She'll bring the whole county down.
Shut her up. What's wrong?
It's my gun. I must have dropped it, but... I'm gonna borrow your horse, Luke.
Hey, where are you going?
I think I know where I lost it. Might be kind of dangerous going back down there.
Well, it'll be more dangerous if somebody finds that gun. It can be traced right to me.
Get impatient. We can't leave till tonight anyway.
Dad! 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 Dad, where are you? Dad!
Ken, what's the matter?
Mom, where's Dad? I've got to see him right away.
Hey, wait a minute, young man. Look how hot and dirty you are.
Oh, please, Mother.
Here, let me wipe your face.
Please, Mother, let me go. He stole Flicka. He took her. I've got to get her back.
Stole Flicka?
Where's Dad? I've got to tell him.
He's shoeing one of the horses.
Dad! 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 The man stole Flicka from me. Dad, I was taking the shortcut over the hill when I came onto him. His horse was lame, and I stopped to see if
I... Now, wait a minute. Take it easy. I thought nobody but you could ride Flicka.
She bucked him off once, but he got on her again. He dug his spurs into her. He would have killed her.
Who was this man?
Oh, I never saw him before. Please go after him right away, Dad.
You bet we will, son.
Gus! Bring three horses. Yeah, Captain. Right the way.
You're coming with me, son. You know which road he took. Now, get your saddle.
Rob, I don't want him there if he's going to be any trouble.
I'll send him back just as soon as he shows us the road.
Thank you.
took off that way.
What did he look like?
He was no Callahan or anything like that.
Well, he were a pretty good man with a horse if he could stay on Flicka.
Only because he scared her. He was wearing dark clothes and...
Well, never mind. If we see him on Flicka, that'll be enough. You ride on back home. Gus and I'll follow the trail.
But I want to go with you.
A man's desperate enough to see if a horse is dangerous. You go on home.
Hiya, Button.
Hey, what did you do with Flicka? Where is she?
She's safe enough.
She's not going to be safe until she's back home with me.
That horse is something pretty special to you, isn't she, Button?
She sure is. If anything happens to her, I'll... Please give her back to me, mister. I'll do anything if you'll just give her back.
I didn't steal your horse, son. I just borrowed her.
And what did you do with her?
Well, I might ask you the same question about a gun I dropped around here.
The gun?
Where is it?
I left it back at the ranch.
Well, I think you better go get it.
Not until I get Flicka.
I want that gun, boy. When I get it back, you'll get your horse back.
You're one of those hold-up men who killed Mr. Neal.
Well, you ought to be careful, boy, who you go accusing. Of course, if I did kill a man, stands to reason it'd be pretty easy for me to kill a horse, huh?
You wouldn't.
Now, look, you've got my gun, I've got your horse. I think we'd better hurry, don't you? Oh, another thing. Forgot to tell you. Just in case I don't get back, you'll find your horse with a bullet in her head. I left instructions. Come on. Who's that?
That's my mother.
Anybody else here?
Nope. Dad and Gus are out looking for Flicka.
All right, son. If you want your horse back, go on and get that gun.
Did they find Flicka?
They're still out looking. I came on home like Dad told me.
Well, don't worry too much about her. They'll find her.
No, yeah.
Isn't it in your room?
I already looked there.
Well, it's around somewhere.
But I want it now. Did you find Flicka, Dad?
Something came up that's more important than looking for a horse. We ran into a deputy on the hills. Fred Neal was killed by road agents.
Oh, no.
Gus is out now telling the other ranchers what they should have known 2 hours ago. A job you should have done, Ken.
I meant to. I forgot.
We could have had every road covered if you'd delivered the sheriff's message. Instead, while 3 murderers are on the loose, we were out looking for Flicka.
Rob, she's important to Ken. Worrying about her made him forget everything else.
They have deputies out now looking for the killers. I only hope they're not wasting their time.
Mother, I've got to find my coat. It's very important.
What's so important about your coat?
Must be around somewhere.
Here it is. Where did you get this? I ask you where you got this gun. It's been fired, too, and not long ago. What about it, Ken?
Ken? Ken, darling, can't you tell us something about it? Can't you explain?
No, I can't.
A few hours ago, the depot was held up, and a man killed. And instead of bringing word home like you were supposed to, you sent me off on a wild goose chase looking for your horse. And now I find this in your pocket.
Ken, darling, can't you explain? Can't you tell us something?
Listen, son, when a decent citizen is killed, everyone should be concerned. And instead of letting me know about it, you forgot and may have given the killer a chance to get away.
Please, Rob.
Now, listen, I want an explanation.
Well, you're not going to get it this way, acting like a cavalry officer. After all, he is your son.
I'm sorry. Your mother's right. But a killing. Ken, all I want is a simple answer to a straight question. Do you know anything about Fred Neal's killing? Well, where did you get this gun?
Ken.
All right. I guess we'll just have to go talk to the sheriff. Come on, son.
Ken. Ken, can't you tell me?
No, Mother. I can't.
Come on, son. I guess they're still out looking. That's where I should be.
Well, hello. If you're looking for the sheriff, you probably won't be back for a couple of days. A lot of excitement around here, you know. A big money shipment stolen, man killed.
Yes, I heard about that.
My name's Simmons. I'm railroad inspector on this section.
I'm Rob McLaughlin. This is my son, Ken.
Howdy, son. I just got in from Green River. I heard about Fred Neal, our telegrapher. Wish I could have been here before it happened. I might have been able to prevent it. Well, is there anything I can do for you?
What I came to see the sheriff about should interest you, too.
It's a mean piece of hardware you got there.
Yes. My son picked it up out near our ranch. It's railroad equipment. Been fired once, too.
Is that so? Let's have a look at it.
I don't know if it had anything to do with Fred Neal's killing or not, but it might have.
Where'd you get this gun, son?
I can't get him to tell me a thing. I'd hoped he'd tell a sheriff.
I see. Well, you tell me about it, won't you, son? It shouldn't take long to check on this gun. I'll have to wire the central office to find out who it was issued to. Want to come along and watch me send the message, sonny? Kids always get a big kick out of watching the telegraph key. You coming, Button?
Go ahead, son. Go on.
Sure. Come on, son.
Well, that was nice work, Button. For a while there, I wondered whether you were going to blab and maybe get your father hurt.
When do I get my horse back?
Well, if you can keep a tight rein on your tongue, you might come around tonight, alone.
Where have you got her?
There's an old mine diggings a few miles north of your place. Do you know it?
Larson's mine. But it's hard for me to get away after dark.
Nothing easy in this world, Button. Guess you'll just have to manage it somehow. Anyway, if you want your horse, you be there at 8 o'clock tonight.
Ken, you're not eating. Your dad will look for Flicka again in the morning. You will, won't you, Rob?
Yeah, I guess so.
Did that railroad man, Mr. Simmons, say when he was going to get the report on the gun?
May I be excused? I'd like to go to my room.
All right, Ken. Go ahead.
About it, Frank. You gonna try to ride the bronc again?
Yeah, I got a fresh horse coming. Don't worry about me.
Come on, Luke. We better get started. We're gonna make that border before morning.
Okay. So long, Frank.
Let's go. What would you do, Button? Ah, so you found the place all right.
I'll get even with you somehow for what you did to Flicka. You didn't have to beat her like that.
You ought to be thankful I kept my word and let you have your horse back. I'll take her and get going. And thanks for the fresh horse.
What did you do with that
horse?
What did you do with that?
You've done enough killing Mr. Neal and whipping Flicka. Stop it, Flicka. Stop it. You've had enough, Flicka. Stop it.
Inspector.
He's the one who stole Flicka. That gun was his, too. I wanted to tell you, but he had Flicka and... Hello, Mother.
I thought you were in bed, son. How did you manage to...
Well, after I caught the saddle horse, I used the rope. Then I got Flicka to haul
What I mean is, how did you manage to catch him?
Oh. Flicka did that.
Well, luckily, we caught the other two men. They could have gotten away clean. By keeping silent when you should have told your father the whole story, you nearly let them all escape. I hope you realize that, son.
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I know it was wrong.
I guess I'll never understand why you acted the way you did. But after all, you did bring in the murderer with a little help from Flicka.
We better be going along now.
Thanks for coming in.
I understand why you did it, son.
I had to save Flicka.
Sure you did. But next time, tell your folks what's bothering you. They can always help you. That's what parents are for.
I'll remember that, Dad.